my name's Pollock, and I'm a program manager on the Microsoft Edge WebView2 team. And today I'll be talking about building, deploying, and managing WebView2 applications. First, I'm excited to announce that WebView2 is officially GA. So now is the time to start building and deploying WebView2 applications. Second, I'll walk you through some case studies about how Microsoft is embracing WebView2 technologies. Third, I'll walk you through a quick demo just to show you how easy it is to get started building with WebView2 in WinForms. And fourth, I'll show you how to effectively manage WebView2 applications as they begin to appear within your organization. So first, what is WebView? WebView is Microsoft's new, modern, embeddable browser control built on top of Microsoft Edge and the Chromium platform. WebView2 allows native developers to use web technologies like HTML, CSS, and JavaScript to build out parts or their entire native application. If this is your first time hearing about WebView2, I recommend that you check out the talk we gave at last year's Ignite that I've linked below on the slide. Last year at Ignite, we introduced the WebView2 runtime, or independent browser bits that WebView2 applications require to run. Now, there are two ways to distribute WebView2 applications with the WebView2 runtime. The first is the evergreen distribution mode, and the second is the fixed distribution mode. So in the evergreen distribution mode, WebView2 applications point to a shared WebView2 runtime on the box. Because it is a shared component, there is just a minimal additional disk footprint. Now in the fixed version, the WebView2 runtime is packaged with the application. This leads to a significantly higher disk footprint. Now the second difference is the update model. In the evergreen distribution mode, the WebView2 runtime that's shared and on the box is updated automatically by Microsoft at the same pace as the Microsoft Edge browser. This ensures that WebView2 developers get access to the latest and greatest web platform with all new feature requests, bug fixes, and security patches. Now for the fixed version, where the WebView2 runtime is packaged with the application, it is up to the developer to update the WebView2 runtime at their own pace. Now this leads to differences in compatibility testing. So for evergreen developers, where the WebView2 runtime is updated automatically, it's important to continuously test your application and WebView2 content the same way that web developers do, which is continuously against the non-stable channels of Microsoft Edge. For fixed version distribution developers, compatibility testing can be done at your own pace and your own cadence, as it is up to the developer how and when they want to update the WebView2 runtime. That's why we only recommend the fixed distribution mode in scenarios when compatibility is of the utmost importance. So as I mentioned earlier, WebView2 is officially GA. WebView2 is GA for Win32 developers, .NET developers using WinForms and WPF, and is currently in preview with WinUI 3.0, and will GA with WinUI 3.0 later this year. Both distribution modes I mentioned, the evergreen and fixed distribution modes, are also now GA. So now is the time to start building and deploying WebView2 applications. And along the way, if you get stuck or have any questions, please connect with us in our feedback repo linked below. So now that WebView2 is GA, Microsoft is really embracing WebView2 technology in two ways. First, to improve experiences that were based on legacy versions of the browser control, and two, to create new experiences in their native applications. So the first case study I want to highlight is the Config Manager Custom Tabs experience. Config Manager is an application IT administrators can use to manage other applications within their organization. So Config Manager has a Custom Tabs experience in the Software Center. This allows IT administrators to pin some of their top websites within the Software Center. So as you can see on the left, the IT administrator has pinned Microsoft.com in their Software Center. Previously, the Config Manager loaded this website via the Internet Explorer-based browser control. This created problems because Microsoft is a modern website, and when loaded on a legacy web browser control, it led to security errors and script errors, as you can see on the left. Now, the Config Manager team heard your feedback loud and clear on the user voice. And currently in technical preview and to be released later this year, is a new custom tabs experience built with WebView2 that you can see on the right. Here, Microsoft.com load seamlessly without any script or security errors. So this is a great example about how Microsoft is modernizing their applications that were using older versions of the browser control with WebView 2. Now, the second case study I want to highlight is Microsoft Outlook. Microsoft Outlook is improving their native application with WebView 2. So as you can see on the left, Microsoft Outlook has always had a meeting insights feature on their web version of Microsoft Outlook. Now, the Outlook team wanted to create the same experience in their native application, and they can easily with WebView 2. WebView 2 allows them to even share the same code base. So this is a great example about how Microsoft is using WebView 2 to improve their native application experience. So you've seen that WebView 2 is GA and that Microsoft is embracing WebView 2. So you may be wondering, just how easy is it for you to get started with WebView 2? Now I'm going to show you just how easy it is to get started building with WebView 2. So over here, I have a WinForms project loaded in Visual Studio. Now this will work for any of the other flavors of WebView 2 that I mentioned previously. So the first thing I'm going to do is make sure that I have WebView 2 installed. Now the WebView 2 API is distributed via NuGet. So I'm going to go Project, Manage NuGet Packages. And as you can see, I have the WebView 2 NuGet package installed. Now, if it wasn't installed, I would go Browse, search for WebView 2, click on the first package that shows up, and then install. But now you can see I already have WebView 2 installed. So the next thing I'm going to do is open up the designer. And all I need to do is just drag and drop WebView 2 from the toolbox into the app. And I can expand it to fill it up completely. Great. Now I can go to the properties over here on the bottom right, and I'm going to set the source property to html5test.com. The source property sets the first URL that the WebView 2 navigates to. So now there are two things going on here. On the left, I have the Internet Explorer-based browser control, and on the right, you've just seen me drag and drop the new WebView 2 control. Now, both are going to navigate initially to the html5test.com. html5test.com will give each web platform a score out of 555 to show how effective it is. So now I'm going to click Start. So you can see I've loaded the Internet Explorer browser control on the left and the WebView 2 control on the right. So I'm going to scroll down here. And you can see the Internet Explorer-based version scores just 312 out of 555 points. And on the right, the WebView 2 control scores 523 out of 555 points. You can see just how much improvement has been made with WebView 2 over Internet Explorer. So hopefully you've seen just how easy it is to get started and just how much better WebView 2 is over the Internet Explorer-based browser control. Great. So now that WebView 2 is GA, and you've seen that Microsoft is building WebView 2 applications, and you've seen just how easy it is for you to start developing WebView 2 applications, you may be wondering, how do you manage these applications effectively as they begin to appear within your organization? So you can manage WebView 2 applications via group policies. These group policies can be set in Intune or Config Manager. And there are three sets of group policies to think about. The first are the Microsoft Edge browser policies. These policies govern how the browser behaves. WebView 2 applications are independent of the Microsoft Edge browser policies. This way, as an IT administrator, when setting group policies for the browser, you do not need to worry about how those will affect WebView 2 applications. So for example, if you disable JavaScript on certain websites, you don't have to worry about that affecting JavaScript-based experiences like Meeting Insights and Outlook. The second bucket of group policies are Microsoft Edge update policies. Here, WebView 2 applications are mostly independent. The evergreen WebView 2 runtime will not get updated if you set quiet hours. In those quiet hours, neither Microsoft Edge will be updated nor the WebView 2 runtime. Now, there are also ways when they act independently. For example, you can set different pause times for when you don't want Microsoft Edge to be updated and when you don't want the WebView 2 runtime to be updated. Now, the third bucket of group policies are WebView 2 specific policies. There are a few that relate to app compatibility. However, our intention is for WebView 2 developers to create their own set of group policies for their own applications. and this can be done on top of existing WebView2 APIs. So that was a quick glance at how to think about managing WebView2 applications. For a more comprehensive guide, check out the link below. So just to recap, WebView2 is officially GA for Win32, WinForms, and WPF developers. So now's the time to start building and deploying WebView2 applications. Microsoft definitely is. And finally, as an IT administrator and you see these applications start appearing within your organization, there are ways to effectively manage them. To learn more about Microsoft Edge, check out microsoft.com/edge/business. For more information about WebView2, check out aka.ms/webview2. And to watch more videos like this one, check out the Microsoft Edge YouTube channel. Thank you so much and happy building.